Sunday. Amen. Another opportunity to give him some more praise. Amen. Amen. God is good. Amen. Hey, despite the weather, despite the circumstances that we're in right now, despite all that's going around us, and despite all that we're going through, God is still a good God. Amen. Amen. He's good all by himself. Amen. Right now, we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. We're going to ask that if you have a prayer request, you stand and let it be known, or you just raise your hand. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Walker. Things lightly, because if it was your child, you'd want someone to pray for them. Sister Shigar.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So much to pray for. Remember, man, woman, boy, and girl in all walks of life. Amen. Not just those that are here, but we have a duty, I should say, to pray for the world. Amen. Amen. That's what we were put here to help save the world, to pray for the world, pray for the sick and the afflicted everywhere. Amen. Amen. So let's not take these responses lightly. Let's honestly pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Remember, Mother Davis, Pastor said this morning that she had something wrong with her foot. Pray that God will grant her deliverance on her foot, heal it. Amen.
Amen.
And bless her. Amen. Sister LaShawn.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
I desire to pray for those saints. I desire that we praise one for another. Mm-hmm. And let's remember the whole body of Christ as a whole.
Yes.
Let's remember that God should add to the church.
Yes. Amen. Pray for the leaders of the churches. Amen. This is a time now where a lot of people can get discouraged. Amen. So pray for the leaders. They need encouraging too. Give pastor an encouraging word sometimes. Amen. Amen. All right. If none others, ask everyone. Bishop Wesley Davis?
Yes.
All right. We'll pray for him. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Any other prayer requests? Pray for Christian ministries. Amen?
Amen.
Pray that God will send in souls, send in helps for the church. Electricians, plumbers, whatever we might need. Amen?
Amen.
You don't want to have to pay for that stuff all the time. Pray that God will send us in some helps. Amen? People that know how to do things in the church. Amen? Musicians, amen. Pastor said he wanted a complete band. I want to see the horn too. I like the saxophone too. I like the electric guitar. I like the bass guitar. I like violins. I like all of that stuff, amen. Amen. So they're out there, amen. So let's pray that God send them in, amen. Deacon Fields. Sister Burgess, amen. Any other requests? All right, let us stand, please. Saints, don't stop praying for the Lord.
Right.
say hallelujah in this place. We give you thanks in this place. We lift you up in this place, Lord. We magnify your name. We give you glory. We give you honor. We say hallelujah. We say hallelujah in the highest. We say hallelujah in the highest. You're the King of kings. You're the Lord of lords. You are strength. You are our refuge. Lord, we say thank you. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for starting us on our way. Thank you for being a very present help in the time of trouble, in the time of need. Now we ask you, Lord, that you look on each and every request that's been made known to you, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you look upon those that are sick, those that are going through, those that are dealing with this virus. We ask you, Lord, bless those, Lord, even those that are having surgeries, Lord, those, Lord, that are having ailments, Lord. Your arm is not short. We ask you, Lord, that you send forth your healing in the name of Jesus. Send forth your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Lord, by your stripes, we are healed. By your stripes, we are delivered. By your stripes, we are set free. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask you to bless us, Lord. Each and every request. Lord, fill this house. Fill this place. Fill our hearts. Fill us with thine anointing. Save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. Lord, save us. Save us from ourselves. Save us from all wickedness. Save us from the hand of the enemy. Save us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you be mindful of this service. Be mindful of our praise. Mindful of our worship. Mindful of our giving. Mindful of our offering. Mindful of us in the name of Jesus. Lord, have your way. Have your way. Have your way in this place. Lord, you wash us, you cleanse us, and purge us from all unrighteousness in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Please remain standing for the reading of the word.
Amen. Turn to the 23rd division of Psalms. Everybody who knows me knows that this is my favorite.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It reads, the Lord is my shepherd. That's relationship. I shall not want. That's supply. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. That's rest. He leadeth me beside the still waters. That's refreshment. He restoreth my soul. That's healing. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness. That's guidance. For his name's sake. That's purpose. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that's testing. I will fear no evil. That's protection. For thou art with me. That's faithfulness. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. That's discipline. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. That's hope. Thou anointest my head with oil. That's consecration. My cup runneth over. That's abundance. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. That's blessing. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord. That's security. Forever. And that's eternity. Praise Him. Thank you. We don't take it lightly, Father, because you did have to do it, but you did. Hallelujah. You did have to do it, but you did, Father. And we appreciate, Father. We appreciate you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And we're here to present our lives as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable, Father, which is our reasonable service. That's the least we can do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You're worthy. Thank you, Father. And I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. back from their vacation. Amen. We missed y'all. Amen. Amen. I saw on Facebook where they were having so much fun. I told them, all right, now that's enough. Come on back home. Amen. That's enough. Amen. Making me want to be there splashing in the water. Amen. Amen. They had a beautiful vacation, it seems. Amen. But we're so glad they're back. Amen. Amen. Right now we're going to ask Sister LaShawn if she would come up and bless us with a solo. Amen. Amen. Sister LaShawn. Amen. Amen. I want all of y'all, I want y'all to get up and let's praise the Lord. Amen. If we praise Him with her, yeah, that would be a bigger help. Amen.
Thank you.
like Jesus. One songwriter said, I searched the whole wide world. I searched here and I searched there. Looked everywhere, but I didn't find nobody great. Nobody great. Hallelujah, than Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I searched all over. Tried to stop doing things I was doing. Going here, going there. But I couldn't find nobody greater. Nobody greater than the man Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. He's the only one I know that'll pick you up, turn you around, set your feet on a solid ground. He'll pick you up. Without him, we can do nothing. You couldn't do nothing without the Lord. Amen. I would have fainted a long time ago had I not seen the goodness of the land, Lord, in the land of the living. Amen. I saw what he was doing for you and 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 you. Don't you let him go. You got eternal life abiding in your soul. Amen. That's the best thing that could ever happen to you is Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I thought when I got married, that was the best thing that could happen to me. I soon found out otherwise. Hallelujah. A lot of work in marriage. A lot of work. Hallelujah. You think then you're going to have it easy. A lot of work in marriage, amen. I thought when my husband upgraded my diamond ring, and that was one of the best things that he could have done. But when I got on my knees and cried Abba Father in another language, that was the best thing that could ever happen to me. Hallelujah. And you know what? I ain't gonna let it go. Sometimes I tell let you use it for about a day. Let you see how it works, how good it is, but you might not give it back. So I can't risk that. You're going to have to get it for yourself, amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I don't want to have to start fighting after these 40 years, trying to get my Holy Ghost back out of you. So you're going to have to get it for yourself, amen. Oh, hallelujah. Hey, every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Hallelujah. He's just that good, amen. He's just that good, amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to have to shut up because you know the preacher gets to talking and keep on talking. Amen. Bishop going to preach for us this morning. And I know he got a rhema word for us. Amen. So right now we're going to change the order of our service. Amen. We're going to ask Stephen Fields if you would come up. Amen. I have no afternoon announcements except for there's Bible class Wednesday at 6 p.m. I saw y'all had a time here last Wednesday, and I wanted to cry, amen. I was sick because I wasn't here, amen. Oh, I was enjoying it at home, but it ain't nothing like being here, amen. Getting the full effect of it, amen. I was so mad at Bishop. I said, he ain't prayed like that in all these 13 years I've been with him. I said, not tonight. I ain't there. He gonna show out. I'm like, Lord, I mean, he prayed, as the old folks say, and he prayed, and he prayed, and he prayed, amen, he just kept praying. I'm like, goodness, Bishop, come on, don't do me like that. About four times he stopped and started again. I was so upset with him, but I said, ain't nobody fault but my own, amen. You let that old tired demon tell you, you tired, amen. That's when you need to press out. When he tells you you don't need to go to church, there's something there waiting on you, amen? That might be your victory moment, amen? That might be your deliverance moment, amen? Hallelujah. So I'm telling you, press your way on out, amen? Y'all ain't gonna get it no more without me. Amen. That was just too much for me. I said, Lord, help me, Jesus, to press. Let's get in the press, amen? Hallelujah. We didn't have to press in the world, did we? And we didn't go out till like 10 o'clock. Yeah. Amen. And you stayed out till 3 or 4 in the morning. And you didn't press at all. But now when you got to go to church, oh, I'm so tired. The enemy just puts tiredness on your shoulders. But if you just press over that, God has a blessing for you. Amen. Amen. See, I'm greedy, y'all. I ain't want y'all getting no more than I get. Amen. Amen. I wanted some of that too. I felt like just coming the way I was, and I looked it bad. Amen. I know it, Bishop. I know. I will next time. Amen. But I hope it ain't gonna be no next time. Amen. Amen. God is good. Right now, we're gonna go before the Lord with our morning's offering. Amen. You're so blessed to have an opportunity to give unto the Lord, to sow into his kingdom one more time. Amen. Amen. And we can't beat God giving. He loves a cheerful giver. Amen. If you bless God, he'll bless you back. Amen. Amen. So we're going to give the Lord a good offering this morning, aren't we? So we still have our jobs. If we don't have jobs, God is still blessing us one way or another. Amen. But he sees to our provision, doesn't he? I don't think anybody in this room is lacking for anything. Hallelujah. Anybody in here don't have any food?
Hallelujah.
Anybody in here don't have a roof over their head?
Hallelujah.
I didn't think so. Hallelujah. Everybody got clothes on their back, yes, shoes on their feet. Yes, amen. I don't see nobody going without. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You can't be God-given. So let's bless the Lord this morning according to how he has blessed us. Amen. Amen. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for an opportunity to give one more time, Lord, to sow into your kingdom. We ask you, Lord, that you'll look on Christian ministries, Lord. Look on the members, Lord. Asking that you'll bless them, Lord, tenfold, thirtyfold, sixtyfold, hundredfold, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Open up the windows of heaven and pour them out a blessing, Lord, that they won't have room enough to receive it. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, I'm going to ask everyone to stand, please.
For he is good.
present to some, and we're going to introduce to others our beloved bishop. Let's receive him with a hearty amen. Bishop Ricky L. Queen.
He's worthy to be praised. And as we get ready to go before the Lord, amen, we certainly do want to thank God for your liberal giving. Amen. How you have blessed the Lord. And those that are online, we still have an opportunity to give through Tithely. Amen. Tithely. Just go on to Tithely. Look up Christian Ministries of the Apostolic Faith Church. Amen. And then select us. And go through the steps, and you'll be able to give. Also, another means of giving is through our drop box. We have a drop box here at the church. Amen. So drop it in our box, and we'll collect it. Amen. So you can get credit from the Lord. So we certainly do thank God for all that he is and all that he is doing. Amen. Let us just stand just for a moment. Amen. Let us bow our heads as we get ready to go before the Lord in prayer. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we certainly do thank you for this great moment. We thank you for this opportunity to stand behind this sacred desk and to preach your anointed word.
Yes,
we ask you, Lord, that you bless each and every soul that is here on today, that we may receive of your word with meekness, that we may grow thereby. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would destroy every yoke, that you would break down every stronghold, that you would tune in our hearts and our minds, that we may hear what thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Lord, we rebuke every evil spirit and every demonic power. And Lord, we pray and we seek your face. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And as we get ready to go before the Lord, we just want to say thank you. Amen. Thank you for being here on today. Thank you for how good God is to each and every one of us. We certainly do honor our lovely wife, Lady Tracy King. Amen. We praise God for her. Amen. We certainly do honor Pastor Eloise Duck. Amen. Amen. Beautiful woman of God. And those that are out on sick leave, we thank God for you all as well. And we thank God for each and every one of you that are here on today. Come on, give God a praise. Amen. Amen. And we truly want to magnify the name of the Lord, for he is great, and he's greatly to be praised. From the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, he is greatly to be praised. All right, Pastor, don't steal my notes. Oh, Jesus. Thank you. That's all right. Be with you. Be with you. Amen. Amen. We certainly do magnify the name of the Lord. And as I'm going to ask Sister Tanasha if she would get one of my hand towels for me, I'd appreciate it. Make it ugly up in here. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. So we want to be prepared. Amen. I was listening to Pastor Duck as she was talking about being in the middle of it. She preached that sermon one day. I don't know if y'all remember that. She preached a sermon in the middle of it. And sometimes we are in the middle of it. And what we got to do, we got to praise our way out of it. If you're in the middle of it, you got to praise your way out of it. If you're in the middle of it, you got to thank God, amen, and give God glory until he sees you through. So we thank God for being in the middle of it. Amen? Hallelujah. That means we're halfway through. And we certainly do praise God, amen, for he is good to each and every one of us. And as we get ready for our announcements, as far as announcement goes, amen, we want you to remember Wednesday night Bible study, as Pastor Duck was talking, so that we can receive of the word of God. We're in a stage and we're in a position now, talking to the all of you all that are here and those that are out there in virtual land with Christian Ministries, that we need to hear the voice of the pastor. We need to hear the voice of the leader.
Yes.
Amen. We need to hear the word of the Lord coming from the leader.
Yes.
Because that word is crucial to our next step. That word is crucial to your anointing. That word is crucial to your breakthrough. That word is crucial to your next season. Amen. Come on and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God has some things for us. Amen. How many of you believe that today? God has some things for you. Hallelujah. And God wants you to receive what he has for you in this season. And we also want to remind everyone to keep the mask on. Keep your face covered. Amen. Put it up above your nose. Amen. That's the proper way. We had them PPB classes. They tell you how to wear your mask. They put it above your nose. Thank you, Lord. Use your hand sanitizers. And we want to be mindful of everybody. Amen. President-elect Biden, he said he's going to challenge people to wear masks. 100-day mask challenge. We should already be in that 100-day mask challenge. Thank you, Jesus. So we're just reiterating something that we should already be doing.
Amen.
Amen. So without further ado, we want you to just stand one more time with me for the reading of the Word of God. And I want you to turn with me to the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter number 30. And we certainly do thank God for those that have been on vacation and have come back, and those that have been out on sick leave and come back. We certainly do praise God for that. And we certainly do praise God for each and every soul. So if you can stand, please stand with me and turn to 1 Samuel chapter number 30. And drop down with me, very familiar passage of scripture. People quote it all the time. Verse number 6. Amen. 1 Samuel chapter number 30 and verse number 6. And it reads as thus, "And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord." And I want to read that last part there. "But David encouraged himself in the Lord." And can we say that together? "But David encouraged himself in the Lord." And I just want to instead of David, put your name right there. Amen. Speak this word unto yourself. Speak this word to yourself. Amen. 1, 2, 3. "But Frank encouraged himself in the Lord his God." Come on and give God a praise. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I want to preach from a subject this morning. Encourage yourself in the Lord. Encourage yourself in the Lord. And sometimes that may feel like it's hard to do, amen, to encourage ourselves in the Lord. And as we're looking at this particular text, as we delve in this particular text, David and his men, at this point in the stage of David's life, he was literally a renegade. He was on the run. And David found himself in a place called Ziklag. David had some marauders, some raiders that were with him, and they joined themselves with David, and the Bible says it was about 600 men and their families that joined themselves with David, and the families were together, and they would go to certain places and raid, and that's how they would get their goods, that's how they would get things to survive on, because they would take it from the hands of the enemy. And at this particular time in the life of David, and he was raiding, that he found himself in a place called Ziklag, which was given to him by a Philistine king. It was given to him by a Philistine king. And that's going to be very important as we get into our lesson here on today, that it was given to him by a Philistine king. You remember the Philistines, that was the one that David first slew out of Goliath. He was from the land of Philistine, out of the place called Gath. And David, that's where he earned recognition, him and Goliath, and he slew Goliath. And we can see the state of David now, that even his enemies are turning around and giving him land, because King Saul was after David at this point in the lesson. He was trying to kill David because David was said to kill his tens of thousands while Saul killed his thousands. Yeah. And Saul got jealous over David. You got to watch folks that get jealous over your anointing. Watch people that get jealous over your position with God, because they'll be out to kill you. They'll be out to chase you down and gather up men to wipe you out. And that's what was happening to David. David had to run away from Saul because Saul was trying to wipe him out. And we see here in this particular lesson that some of the kings came and they were trying to take him over. Thank you, Lord. They were trying to take him over. And as David was out there, David had faced, stole things from the Amalekites. And this, y'all bear with me just for a minute. He stole some things from the Amalekites. And you got to understand that the Amalekites, they weren't just some type of army. They were some ruthless folk. They raped, they killed, they murdered everybody they went into to take their stuff. The Amalekites were some people that they were afraid of. And that's why, and literally Saul, the first king of Israel, lost his position, because God told Saul to utterly destroy the Amalekites, and he failed to utterly destroy them. Don't you know that things that you fail to do with God, when God gives you a command and tells you to utterly destroy or to let stuff go or to move away from it, if you don't, it'll come back to haunt you. It'll come back to do you evil. So it's better to obey God. It's better to obey God in the beginning. If God tell you to have no mercy on a situation, don't have no mercy on the situation. I remember the story of a saint of God. The saint of God is here in this room. Somebody told her to get all your bills together, and we'll pay them all for you. And she left out one bill. That one bill gave her a headache. Amen. You don't leave nothing out. You got to do everything that God has told you to do. No matter how you feel about it, if God said it, you got to do it. If God has put it in your heart, put it in your mind, you got to do it. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. And that's the way the Amalekites were. They continued to nag at the children of Israel, and they continued to nag at David and the rest of the children of Israel, until David was one day, he was robbing from them, and he was robbing from other people. And at this point in time, David's life, he had left himself open as he was going off raiding. And then the Amalekites came to the camp. And look at God. The Amalekites came to the camp. And remember, I told you they were some ruthless folk. They were some evil folk. They stole David's stuff. They stole David's man's stuff. They stole their family. But the Bible says they were great and small, but God didn't allow them to kill any one of them. That's the hand of God. That's the power of God. Well, the enemy may try to come up against you, but the enemy can just go but so far. So we have to ask ourselves, how did we get to this point in the game? How did David find his stuff missing? How did David find everything taken from him? And not only him, but also his men, those that were with David. Their children were taken. Their stuff were taken. Their wives were taken. And everything that they had was taken. And when they got back to the camp, everything was gone. So we have to ask ourselves, what was the condition, what was the situation that they were going through that the Lord allowed this thing to happen. So we see here that we understand that David was a man that was chosen of God. The Bible says that David was a man after God's own heart. So David was anointed to be king over Israel. God gave him a position. God gave him authority. God gave him power. But when Saul tried to come and kill David, instead of David standing up to Saul, Saul, hallelujah, put the fear in David's heart. In other words, David began to allow fear to move him from his assignment with God. My friend, don't allow fear to chase you. Don't allow fear to move you from your assignment with God. Fear is something else when it's following and chasing after the child of God. There are three types of fear that try to overtake us. Sometimes we fear evil, but we can't fear evil because God said that I have not given you the spirit of fear, but love, power, and a sound mind. We fear the loss of things. We fear that we're going to lose everything if I step out on God. If I make a change, if I move, I may lose what I have. And that's a fearful thing. That's a fearful thing. And that's why I love Abraham, because God told Abraham that I want you to leave your country. I want you to leave your kindred. Said, I'm going to show you something and I'm going to bless you. And Abraham moved and he believed God. And that's the way we have to handle change. We have to handle change in a certain way that we don't allow it to paralyze us. We fear the loss of finances. We fear the loss of health. We fear the loss of all kind of things. But God is a God that said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto you. Those things that you don't confront will get bigger in the end. Those things that you don't stand up to will get harder in the end. In other words, that if you fear anything and you don't step up to it, that what you fear in the end is going to give you trouble. In the end, it's going to cause you to disbelieve God. In the end, it's going to be harder for you to fight. So that's why it's better for you to fight that thing in the beginning. That's why it's better for you to stand hardly at that thing in the beginning. That's why it's better for you to stand up and declare that by no means I'm going to allow my fear to control me. I'm the child of God. We've been bought with a price, and we're going to stand up to whatever may come our way. My God, you got to stand up to those things which you fear that are going to happen to you, because God has not given you that kind of spirit. God has not given you that kind of anointing. God has not given you that kind of power. That's why we ought not fear the hand of the enemy. That's why we not fear what man shall do unto us. The Bible says that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You've got to talk to yourself and say, the Lord is my refuge. The Lord is my fortress. The Lord is my strength. I will dwell in the shadow of the Almighty. I will not fear what the enemy shall do. Don't fear what the enemy shall bring you. Because when God is near, your power is near. When God is near, he can destroy every yoke, break down every stronghold. That's why you got to be strong in the Lord. I'll tell you, neighbor, I'm going to be strong. I'm going to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. If you faith in the face of adversity, your strength is small. But you got to trust in God. Tell somebody, I'm going to trust in God. I'm going to trust in God. I'm not going to allow the enemy to get up a hand on me. I'm going to trust in God. There's nothing to fear but fear itself. Fear is nothing but false evidence appearing real. But we got the Lion of the tribe of Judah. We
us. David found himself. Y'all just be seated just for a moment. David found himself in this particular situation because he was running from Saul. And when he was running from Saul, he found himself afraid. And when David found himself afraid, he started making allegiance with other people outside of the kingdom of God. When you find yourself afraid, you'll find yourself making friends with those no good people that try to come your way. I'm reminded of what God had said in the first Psalms. He said, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. And that's what David found himself. He found himself making allegiance with the Philistines. He found himself making allegiance with people that didn't mean him no good. He found himself making allegiance with renegade people. People that didn't have no honor. People that didn't have no goodness in their hearts. When you're afraid and you allow your assignments to get away from you, you go into what's called a survival mode. And when you're in a survival mode, you eat anything. Oh my God. Y'all remember the prodigal son? He found himself in survival mode. He got thrown into a pig pen and he was eating husk. Hallelujah. That was only meant for those that were no good. That's what you'll find yourself in if you allow yourself to get desperate. You'll find yourself making allegiance with people that mean you no good. You'll go and make friends with unrighteous people, ungodly people, so that you can try to make a way. But I like the prodigal son. The Bible said that he came to himself. When you get down you've got to come to yourself. You've got to realize your daddy is rich. Your daddy is powerful. Now, why do you have to say in this place when your God cares about you? And that's what David found himself in, because of his fear, because of the way people were treating him, because he didn't tackle Saul when he needed to tackle him, and he joined himself with ungodly people. He lost his way. My God, when you allow circumstances and situations to come upon you, and you don't tackle and handle your business, you can lose your way. And when you lose your way, things get harder. The Bible says that the way of a transgressor is hard. David found himself in a position of being a transgressor. Why? Because he allowed fear to move him from his assignment. Never allow fear to move you away from your assignment. Because if it moves you away from your assignment, it'll move you away from your God. And if it moves you away from your God, then you're open to the attacks of the devil. Oh, my God. How many of you know you come too far by faith? You've got too much skin in the game to allow the devil to overtake you. You've done too much. Too much prayer. Too much fasting. Too much trusting. God has invested too much in you. You've been bought with a price. You are not your own. Jesus went to the cross. Jesus died. And he rose again on the third day. And he gave you power. Every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. You gotta talk to yourself and say, I'm not gonna backslide. I'm not leaving here. If there's one thing I know, it's the goodness of the Lord. I will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. And behold, the beauty of the Lord in the land no man, no woman, no boy, no girl, no sir, no man. Don't let nothing turn you back. Every game of Jesus, how many of you know it's sweeter? David allowed fear, the fear of Saul. David got into circumstances and situations where he found himself drifting away from God. God said, tell the people, don't allow fear, the fear of man, the fear of spirits, the fear that is in your heart, to allow it to draw you away, to draw you away from God. If you allow it to draw you away from God, where is your help coming from? If you allow it to draw you away from God, where is your peace coming from? If you allow it to draw you away from God, where is your joy coming from? Because in God, there's joy. In God, there is peace. In God, there is strength. In God, there is healing. In God, there is help. In God, there is resource. In God, there is grace. In God, there is power. And you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. If you leave your strength, you leave in the power of God. Don't let nothing separate you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Don't let peril, don't let nakedness, don't let the sword, don't let it separate you. Don't let man, don't let woman, don't let nothing keep you from your Jehovah Jireh, from your Jehovah Nisi, from your Jehovah Shalom. Don't let nothing pull you away from your steadfastness, because Jesus is, he's that solid rock, he's our Alpha, he's our Omega, he's our beginning, and he's our end. Come on and give God a praise. You ought to praise him. Oh God, you're too valuable for me to leave by the wayside. You're too valuable to my next step. You're too valuable for my next move. You're too valuable to my life to allow anything to take your joy, your peace, your strength away from me. Come on and give God a praise.
Yes. So David, somebody say David. David found himself alone. Hallelujah. When they came back to Ziklag, he found everything missing. He found his woman gone. Not only did he have one woman, he had two. Oh my God. And they were stolen from him. And not only was David's stuff gone, but David's men's stuff was gone. When they got back, they realized that, my God, the Amalekites got them. And they realized, I told you, that the Amalekites were some wicked folk. They slew everything they captured. They killed everything they got their hands on too. And they were some vicious people. But David's men were hungry. David's men were tired. The Bible said they wept and they cried until there was no strength left in them. You see, when you lose your way, oh my God, and you realize
realize you lost everything you had. It'll cause you to weep. It'll cause you to cry. It'll cause you to weep. It'll cause you to cry. If you cry, I hear the word of saying, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Oh, we got a God. If you turn your heart back to him, he's able to comfort you. He's a God of all peace. He's a God of all comfort. Oh, God, you got to realize that what you're going through, if you lost anything, God is trying to get your attention. If you lost anything that was of value to you, God is trying to turn your heart back to him. And that's what is going on with David. David had lost his way. So God allowed the Amalekites to move in and take his family, take his everything that he had, but do no harm to it, to show him that David, you neglected your post. You left yourself open for the attack of the enemy. When you don't turn back, come on, shout. When you don't put your trust in God, when you turn away from God, you leave yourself open for the hand of the enemy. Not only to come in, but to take your stuff, to take your joy, to take your peace, to take your children, to take your job, to take your finances, to take everything from you that you hold near and dear to yourself. And God allowed it, because David, he neglected his God. My brothers and sisters, my sisters and brothers, don't neglect your God. By any means, hold a relationship with him. By any means, call on the name of the Lord. By any means, worship your God. Don't let no trial, don't let no tribulation, don't let nobody separate you from the love of God. Don't let nothing try to hold you back from your worshiping your God. Don't let the devil steal your joy. Don't let the devil steal your peace. Don't let the devil steal your children. Don't let the devil steal your power. Don't let the devil steal whatever God has for you. You ought to give God a praise. So David and his men, I'm almost done, found themselves. My God, we've lost everything. Everything is gone. Everything is stolen. And the Bible says that when this happened, David was greatly distressed. He found himself greatly distressed. For the people, those who he joined himself to, they wanted to stone David. Because they lost everything too. You know, that's why I say you gotta watch out who you friends with. In the time of trouble, they'll turn around and stab you. They'll try to hurt you. You can't buddy buddy with everybody, especially the devil. Especially those that are in the world. They don't care about you. Oh my God, I feel like teaching now. They don't care about you. This is how you know if somebody in love with you or somebody lusting after you.
That's right.
If they in love with you, they care about you. They'll talk about you. They'll help you.
That's right.
But if they lusting after you, they'll just take from you.
That's right.
They don't care about their
Just bear with me, just for a moment. When we stray
stray away from God, God still has his hand on us. God is still watching over us. So God will put things in your way, stumbling blocks if you will, so that you can fall on your knees and begin to cry out to your God, because God loves you. That's where the scripture says, when it talks about, lead us not into temptation, the Lord deliver us from evil. But you've got to understand that your God uses temptation for his good. God doesn't tempt any man with evil, but God created evil so they can bring you back to your pure remembrance, so it can bring you back and to let you know who is the King of Kings, who is the Lord of Lords. You've got to realize that at this moment, David was inquiring of the Lord, and the Lord told David, I want you to pursue, I want you to go after everything that the enemy stole, I want you to go after everything that the devil took. You've got to understand, when you turn your heart back to God, he turns your heart back to purpose, he turns your heart back to his calling, he turns your heart back to his election. Oh my God, y'all don't hear me up in here. You got to know that God has a purpose, that God has a calling, that God has a way, that nobody else can do it but you. Oh my God, and when you tripped off course, God will call something to get down in your face, so you can get down in your knees and ask God, Lord, help me. Help me in this situation. Help me with this problem. Help me in this condition. I'm tired of the enemy taking everything from me. I'm tired of the devil talking smack, smack, and smack. Oh, but you got to know that your God is real. Tell your neighbor, God is real. I can feel him in my hands. I can feel him in my feet. I can feel the Lord all over me. And when the Lord says it's time for you to pursue, you better go. Put on the loins. You better get some strength and go after all that what the enemy stole. And when you go, go in the name of the Lord and say, I shall recover. 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 I shall recover all. Come on and give God a praise. When David got serious, turned his heart back to God, God put him on purpose. Instead of him pursuing things that didn't matter, that's what happens when you take your eye off God. You start going after things that don't matter. You start going after the things that the enemy puts in your heart that doesn't matter. But when you start seeking God, I want y'all to hear me here today. When you seriously start seeking God, God puts you on point to pursue after purpose. Y'all hear me here? Can I say this and y'all don't get mad with me? A lot of people aren't pursuing purpose. That's why they don't have joy. That's why they find themselves struggling. That's why they find themselves with no peace. Because they're not pursuing purpose. When you pursue purpose, help me here, Holy Ghost. When you pursue purpose, even though tests and trials come, they don't bring you down. Instead of it deterring you, you get more motivated.
more dedicated. Then the joy of the Lord becomes your strength. Then the joy of the Lord becomes your power. Then you start confessing. Then you start trusting in the Lord. I had one brother say to me, coming from out of town, he said, Pastor Quinn, I don't just go anywhere on Sundays because I don't want to waste my Sunday. Because I want to go somewhere where I'm going to hear some word. Because I don't want to waste my Sundays. Huh? I don't want to do things that are wasteful. Because when you realize that God has called you, that God has anointed you, this word of the Lord becomes your strength. It becomes your help. It becomes like your next breath. I gotta have it. I gotta have it. If I don't get it, I'm gonna die. When you get yourself rooted and grounded in God, you won't allow anybody. You won't allow anything to take you away from your God. Oh, God, I'm about to preach up in here again. You won't allow testing trials to stand in your way. You won't allow excuses to stop you from moving forward. You won't allow lies from the devil, your own lies, to stop you. Why? Because you know that you and God got an inheritance. That you and God got the victory. That God is your strength. That God is your refuge. That God is your fortress. And if it doesn't happen with me and God, it's not going to happen. That's the mind. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Notice the mind of Christ. When he came up against situations, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death. This is how you know if you're trusting in God. If you humble yourself and become obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Hallelujah. Oh, I ain't preached this way in years. Now let's go back. Huh? If I know you don't mean me no good, if I know you trying to take my joy, if I see a snake in you, if I see that you are trying to rob me of my purpose, rob me of my plan, rob me of my God, away with you. That's the mindset you gotta have. You gotta be what we say in the hood, as serious as a heart attack. I'm serious as a heart attack. Hey! My God. That's the way you gotta be. God ain't gonna get upset with you. They may get upset with you, but hey. When David got serious with God, God put him back on purpose. He told him to pursue. Go after those things that matter, David. Go after those things that matter. You gotta go after those things that matter. Y'all hear me? I got two more minutes. Thank you, Lord. Listen to me. Hallelujah. I've let, and I'm sure you have too, distractions come. Do busy work. Do stuff just to keep yourself busy. Do stuff that you think is important, but all it is a distraction. Come on here, somebody. I'm spending 3 hours trying to make my bed. That's a distraction. Huh? Huh? That's a distraction. Hey, that's a distraction. You follow me? Just make the bed, go to stuff, move on. Go to plan B. That's a distraction. Life is filled with distractions. God says, get rid of the distractions. Pursue after that which is needful. And if you pursue after that which is needful, you'll recover all. God will be with you. Now I just want to say this, and I'm done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sound like I'm fussing a little bit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Y'all still up?
Yeah.
All right, I love y'all too. I'm going to tell y'all the truth. Jesus, Lord, we certainly thank you for this anointing in this place. We thank you for this word in this place. We thank you for the spirit of holiness in this place. Lord, we thank you for pursuing. We thank you, Lord, for encouraging ourselves in the Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you bless us. As though we may be off track, Lord, we repent and we turn from every wicked way to get back on track. Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you dominate our lives, dominate our spirit, dominate our soul. Those people, Lord, that are in our lives that mean us no good, we remove them in the name of Jesus. Lord, those that don't mean us, hallelujah, our prosperity, that are sucking from us. Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you dry them up in the name of Jesus, that we might live. Lord, we pray that you give us a spirit to worship you. Give us a spirit, Lord, to seek your face. Give us a mind to call on your holy name. Turn us from darkness to light. From the power of saved unto you, O God. Bless us, Lord, to connect with the vision. Bless us, Lord, to connect with the purpose. And to pursue. Hallelujah. To go after. That we may recover all. Father, we thank you. Lord, we praise you. In the precious and the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Amen. Love one another from a distance.